So till now we have seen what an arithmetic progression looks like, how to find the nth term and the sum of the first n terms, what a geometric progression looks like, and how to find the nth term and the sum of first n terms, and so on. What happens when there are certain progressions which are a combination of arithmetic and geometric progressions, or they have some common logic which is being repeated in that entire series? So how to go about solving these kind of questions? So these are the special type of problems which involve some concepts from AP and GP, especially infinite GP, and this is how you will solve it. So say for example, there is this problem which says that we have to find the sum of all these terms, which says 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 3 by 8 plus 1 by 4 plus 5 by 32 and so on. How will you find the sum of this? So you can pause the video and try something on your own, and then maybe we can check as to how to go about it. What we can do here is, if you see it carefully, you can see the denominator is 2 here, 8 here, 32 here and so on. So we can just work around a bit and we can say that if it's 1 by 2, then if this has to be 4, then this has to be 2. If this has to be 16, then this has to be 4, because it's 1 by 4 and 1 by 2 respectively. So what happens here is, you can simply rewrite this as 1 by 2 plus 2 by 4 plus 3 by 8 as it is, plus 4 by 16 plus 5 by 32 and so on till positive infinity, right? So what happens here is, the numerators are in arithmetic progression while the denominators are in geometric progression. So it's a mixture of these two concepts. So how to solve these kind of questions? One thing you can do is, there is a big formula which you can memorize and you can solve questions, but that is not really helpful because not every question will be from this prototype. This is just a simple question which I am trying to explain to you, but not every question will look like this. The logic will remain the same, but the question will not be like this. So first we have to assume here that this sum is equal to some value s. Okay, so let's equate this to s. We'll form an equation and then we will start working on it. Now you will see that the numerator differs by 1, the common difference is 1, right? And the denominator is nothing but it's multiplied with a geometric progression with half as the common difference. So if we decrease the numerators by 1 bit everywhere, then it will be very easy to subtract and turn this into an infinite geometric progression. It's very difficult to visualize this when I say it, but now if you multiply this entire equation by 1 by 2, then it will become clearer to you. So let's say we multiply everything by half, okay, which is the common ratio. So half, this will be nothing but 1 by 4, right? 2 by 4 will become 2 by 8, 3 by 8 will become 3 by 16, 4 by 16 will become 4 by 32, 5 by 32 will become 5 by 64, and so on, okay? And this will be nothing but, because you are multiplying LHS by 2 by half, your RHS will also get multiplied by half or divided by 2, whichever way you want to see. Now what happens is, if you see, you can see these terms, right? 2 by 4, 1 by 4, 2 by 8, 3 by 8, 4 by 16, 3 by 16 and so on. So everywhere there will be terms which would cross themselves out or maybe reduce it by 1. So what happens here is, we have simply used the common difference and the common ratio to arrive at something from which you can subtract the earlier, subtract the earlier one and then can get the result. So what we will do is, we will subtract s by 2 from s. So if this is equation 1 and this is equation 2, we will simply subtract equation 2 from equation 1. Because if people are so used to hearing these kind of things, we will solve it in a classy manner if you want. So this is nothing but 1 by 2. It will remain the same because there is nothing 1 by 2 in the denominator. So 1 by 2 will remain the same. 2 by 4 minus 1 by 4 will be nothing but plus 1 by 4. 3 by 8 minus 2 by 8 will be nothing but 1 by 8. 4 by 16 minus 3 by 16 is nothing but 1 by 16 and so on. And s minus s by 2 will be nothing but s by 2. Now you see this and now you have got a pattern. So this is pretty simple from what you started. You started with this and you have got this. So what happens here is, 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 plus 1 by 16 is nothing but an infinite GP, where A, that is the first term, is half. So the sum of infinite GP is nothing but A divided by 1 minus R, given that R is less than 1 and greater than minus 1. In this case, R is half, so that is satisfied. So what happens is, the first term is half and 1 minus R will be 1 minus half again, because R is half. This will be equal to S by 2. So half divided by 1 minus half is nothing but half. So half by half is 1, and so your s will be equal to 2, right? So that's what you started with. You started with this entire thing which said 1 by 2 plus 2 by 4 plus 3 by 8 plus 4 by 16 and something will be equal to s, and you have found out that s is equal to 2. So the sum of this entire series will be equal to 2. So that's how you go about solving these kind of questions. So in case of an arithmetic and a geometric progression being combined, what you can do is you can simply take the common ratio what is there, and you can multiply the RHS with the same and the LHS with the same again and then subtract it. So here, because the common difference is 1, the entire progression came out to be 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 and so on. In case the common difference was 2 or 3 or 4 or whatever, that 3 or 4 or 2 would have come outside and again you would have got the same progression. So in case of combination of AP and GP, what you have to do is multiply it by the common ratio, subtract it, remove the common term, and then go about finding the value of S. So that's how you go about finding sums in case of mixed progressions.